On the northern part of Antarctica was a newly discovered island, revealed by melting ice caps. On this island, they discovered a tribe called Kudasa, and many remains in cave paintings which revealed their philosophies, art culture, and the name of the island, which is called Asaduk. This tribe lived for art and expressed it in many ways. They had perfected a way to make photographs. Although primitive, we were able to recreate the artwork of their lifetime. They also practiced the art of death through sacrifice, mutilation, blood drinking, blunt weapons, the medicine woman, sharp blades, death rituals, mining white gold powder, and shamanistic revelations. The tribe was short-lived and died a horrific fate by an unknown race that descended from the heavens. Kudasa, and many remains in cave paintings which reveal a lost of culture and the name of the island, which is called Asaduk. This tribe lived on art and expressed it in many ways. They had perfected a way to make photographs. Although primitive, we were able to recreate the artwork of their lifetime. They also practiced the art of death through sacrifice, mutilation, blood drinking, block weapons, the medicine woman, sharp blades, rituals, mining white gold powder, and shamanistic revelations. The tribe was short-lived and died a horrific fate by an unknown race that descended from the heavens.
I'm going to go to the next one.
I present my peace as my reflection of your society. Life, death, and our culture's obsession with it. We celebrate dead artist and arrest street artist. The death of art represents our culture's fascination with death, and how we need to accept death as a part of life. Without death, there would be no life. Death of art, Kudasa tribe, and Asaduk island. Thank you.